Hello friends, welcome to Trending Telecast. In this video we are going to see some science news, so let's start the video.
First news come from the European Space Agency said Friday that human urine could one day become a useful ingredient in making concrete to build on the moon. The agency said researchers in a recent study it sponsored found that urea, the main organic compound in urine, would make the mixture for a lunar concrete more malleable before it hardens into its sturdy final form. It noted that using only materials available on site for a moon base or other construction would reduce the need to launch supplies from Earth. Next news, oceans are likely to rise as much as 1.3 meters by 2100 if Earth's surface warms another 3.5 degrees Celsius, scientists warned Friday. By 2300, when ice sheets covering West Antarctica and Greenland will have shed trillions of tons in mass, sea levels could go up by more than 5 meters under that temperature scenario, redrawing the planet's coastlines, they reported in a peer-reviewed survey of more than 100 leading experts. About 10% of the world's population, or 770 million people, today live on land less than 5 meters above the high tide line. Even if the Paris Climate Treaty goal of capping global warming below 2 degrees Celsius is met, a very big if, the ocean watermark could go up 2 meters by 2300, according to a study in the journal Climate Atmospheric Science. After that, Japan's Hayabusa 2 asteroid probe has already accomplished a lot, after launching in 2014 and spending several years traveling to intercept the space rock known as Ryugu. It made many key observations and even took samples of the asteroid before departing and heading back to Earth. The Hayabusa 2 spacecraft, built and operated by the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency, JAXA, fired a 5G metal projectile into the surface of the near-Earth asteroid Ryugu, a spinning top-shaped body with 1 km across and some 350 million kilometers from Earth. This projectile disrupted the surface of the asteroid, allowing Hayabusa 2 to capture some of the lofted material and tuck it safely away on board. Having departed from Ryugu in November 2019, Hayabusa 2 is expected to fly past Earth in late 2020 and release its sample in a re-entry capsule for detailed analyses in labs across the world. Next news, scientists have discovered why the North Magnetic Pole has, in recent years, shifted away from Canada towards Siberia. A team from the University of Leeds in the UK says this is explained by the competition of two magnetic blobs on the edge of the Earth's outer core. The researchers found that the changes in the flow of molten material in the planet's interior have altered the strength of the above regions of negative magnetic flux. The changes in the pattern of flow have weakened the patch under Canada and slightly strengthened the one under Siberia. As a result, the North Pole has shifted from the Canadian Arctic and crossed over the international dateline towards Russia. Thereafter, new snapshots of Jupiter reveal its turbulent weather in infrared, the spectrum of light just beyond visible wavelengths. To get these unprecedentedly sharp images, a team of researchers from NASA and the University of California, Berkeley combined data from the Hubble Space Telescope, the Juno probe that orbits Jupiter, and the Gemini Observatory on Earth. The team released the images alongside a research paper in the Astrophysical Journal on Thursday. Next news, China's latest large carrier rocket made its first successful flight Tuesday, an important step in the nation's plan to build a space station, according to state-run news agency Xinhua. The Long March 5B rocket blasted off from the Wenchang Space Launch Center in South China's Henan Province, sending an unmanned prototype spacecraft and a cargo return capsule successfully into orbit. The new rocket model is a variant of the Long March 5 and can carry larger payloads, up to 22 tons, into low Earth orbit. It was designed to carry space station modules into orbit, said Wang Zhu, chief director of the rocket development team at the China Academy of Launch Vehicle Technology. After that, unsurvivable heat and humidity conditions are already emerging worldwide decades ahead of expectations. A study published Friday in Science Advances identified thousands of unusual or unprecedented bouts of extreme heat and humidity in all the continents except Antarctica. In the Persian Gulf, the researchers spotted more than a dozen incidents in which the temperature and humidity surpassed the theoretical human survivability limit. A sweat can't evaporate if it's too humid, so your body can't cool down and then your organs fail. So far, the outbreaks lasted only hours. but they're increasing in frequency and intensity and are projected to affect wider areas. The most prone areas are the Indian subcontinent, Saudi Arabia, Qatar and the United Arab Emirates, and parts of the United States as well. Under these conditions, even a strong, physically fit person resting in the shade with no clothes and unlimited access to drinking water would die within hours, the researchers observe. Next news, the gutted carcass of a freshwater dolphin has been found in a river sanctuary in Bangladesh, officials said Sunday, sparking fears fishermen are taking advantage of the virus lockdown to poach the endangered creatures. Locals in the southeastern town of Rojan found the remains of the 62-inch 157-centimeter long Ganges River dolphin on the banks of the Haldar River, Fishery Department official Abdullah Al-Mamun told AFP. It had suffered a sharp and deep incision from its neck to tail, and layers of its body fat, from which oil is extracted for use in traditional medicines, were missing, he said. The dolphin is the second to be found dead in the same sanctuary since Bangladesh imposed its lockdown to tackle the coronavirus, said Manzoru Kibria, coordinator of the Haldar River Research Laboratory, HRRL. Thank you for watching this video. For more news like social news, tech news, business news, science news and sports news, do subscribe our channel and stay tuned with us to get such trending news every day. If you liked this video, click on the thumbs up button below and share this video with your friends and families.